from here on out, you're going to manifest 6 different quirks.
What?
Oh my god! Okay, it's happening! Everybody stay calm!
What's the procedure, everyone? What's the procedure?
Stay calm!
Wait.
Everybody calm down!
How is it going, my heroes and villains? What's up, everybody? We are finally back. And I am here to give you guys my reaction to chapter 213 of My Hero Academia, which is entitled Location of the Soul. And it feels so good to finally have a new chapter of MHA. That break that we had in between these last two chapters felt like it was going to go on forever.
One eternity later.
But the dark days are behind us. We got the new chapter, and I can't wait to see what developments go down in this chapter, but also to see what Horikoshi has planned for MHA throughout 2019. But with this chapter in particular, 213, you guys have me really excited right now because some of you guys have been reaching out to me, not spoiling me, but letting me know, Sean, this is an interesting chapter. Stuff happens in this chapter, and that immediately puts a smile on my face when I read that. I'm like, okay, what are we going to get this chapter? I have a suspicion of where we could possibly go, because with last chapter, we ended off with a potential conversation between Deku and our Hellboy Vestige guy. And this is going to be a pretty one-sided conversation, because currently Deku has no mouth, so Hellboy is going to do most of the talking, but I am hoping that he can shed some light onto what is currently going on with Deku, with One For All, and why those black tendrils were just exploding out of Deku's arm. I am hoping that is what we get this chapter, and I am excited to dive into this. So without further ado, let's dive into chapter 213, and let's see what goes down. All right, so we are kicking this chapter off with this conversation. We are within the One For All avatar state, and Deku is going to be talking with our Hellboy. Try harder, dude. If you do, well, things have a way of working out. And Deku is just shocked. His eyes are wide open. I don't have a mouth, so I can't answer. Oh, you've got no mouth, huh? Don't worry about it. Hellboy's like, don't worry. I'll do all the talking. Ooh, I like this panel shot of him. He looks badass, and you see like the smoke as he snorts it from his nose. This guy has seen some battles in his day. He looks awesome. I can see him so clearly. This is way more than just a vestige now. And it's not a dream either. This person, these people, are actually alive inside One For All. I like that shot. The embers, the fires of One For All. And you can see all the predecessors. You still have those two silhouetted out. But these past predecessors, their souls and their connection with the quirk, they are still alive within there, which is something we kind of already knew. But I have a feeling we're going to dive just a little bit deeper into this. Huh, looks like I'm on a time limit here. All right, listen up, kid. Okay, so he doesn't have long, and he needs to tell Deku all that he can within the time limit. The power you just used is my quirk.
Well, duh.
But why was it activated, though? That's what I'm curious about. And this really doesn't come as a shock to me, because it kind of felt like this was going to be a power of one of the previous holders. And I've kind of always thought, based on the way that Horikoshi has set it up throughout the story, that it is a crystallization of power. And I always wondered if the past quirks of other people got incorporated into One For All. And it seems this is definitely the case. So not only has it grown in power, but it stockpiled the previous quirks as well. Deku is gonna have a lot at his disposal, isn't he?
You smart.
You very smart.
Our quirk factors merged with the core of this power and have been inside One For All for a long time. It's a very tiny core, like a small point inside a flickering ember, or perhaps on the surface of rippling water. It's the origin of the power concealed by the cultivated power. And as of right now, that core has begun its quickening. It's expanding and growing larger. And how much more is One For All going to grow? Is it going to become unstable if it continues to grow?
Maybe.
This is going to definitely raise a lot of questions about what could possibly happen with One For All moving forward. What you occasionally see in the intervals between those fluctuations, One For All itself is growing. And Deku is like, but why? What caused this? Just now, were you thinking, I'm gonna capture him or grab him? You were, weren't you? I know you were. I was thinking about capturing Monoma. Exactly. As soon as he was about to like launch that finger flick at Monoma, he's like, I need to take him down. I need to capture him. I guess that was like a trigger that activated Hellboy's power here. And my quirk, Black Whip. Oh, that's cool. So they're like whips. They're not tendrils. They are black whips. So my quirk Black Whip fits those feelings perfectly. You're lucky that I was the first one. This here's a great quirk. I'll have you know. Oh, man. This just has me thinking now, what other quirks could possibly manifest from previous users? And plus, on top of that, how many quirks is Deku going to have? Because, my god, that could possibly be very OP. But the curious thing is, I've actually thought about this earlier on in My Hero, because Horikoshi's kind of laid the groundwork of this.
And so the stockpiling ability merged with the younger brother's power. And that is how One For All came to be. One person improves the power, then hands it off to another person. It continues to grow as it's passed along. It is this cultivated power that allows me to save those who are in need of a hero. The truth behind my strength.
One For All is a crystallization of power. It bolsters quirks. For example, if young Todoroki were to inherit it, the strength added to his own quirk would probably make him an unbeatable superhero.
Every time One For All has been brought up and it has talked about the manifestation and the cultivation of power amongst the users, I always wondered if the previous quirks of other holders got incorporated when they got passed on. And this is giving us the answer. They do. However, the power being accumulated within One For All has also been added to this quirk, which means it's been drastically strengthened compared to when I was using it.
What?
So it's even more OP than when Hellboy was using it right here. Deku has just unlocked all the cheat codes, and now he just needs to master his new skills. Oh man, Deku's journey has literally just begun now. We thought we were making good progress. No, no, no. We are far from the finish line. The journey has just begun. Ah! Something is happening with Hellboy. Deku looks shocked. Whoops, I'm vanishing. I'm starting to feel all floaty. You see, I only exist inside your heart. Remember, if you wield your power in anger, the power will respond accordingly. What's important is always being in control of your heart. Basically, control your emotions, Deku. And it looks like our Hellboy is reaching in, trying to grab Deku's heart. It looks like he's Temple of Dooming Deku. Kalema! Kalema! It's fine to get angry. Anger is one source of power, and that's exactly why you must have careful, extreme control over that anger. He's not saying that it's bad to get angry. Being angry is fine. As long as you can control that anger, that's what you need to do. Just don't let the anger control you. Now that it's been handed down through 8 people, One For All has become enormously powerful. And it looks like our vestige friend, Hellboy's arm, is just beginning to evaporate in front of Deku. I'm guessing his time limit's up. So listen here, boy. All right, Kratos.
Boy, this way, boy. Slow down, boy. We do what we please, boy.
Boy, look at me. Look at me, boy. Boy.
From here on out, you're going to manifest 6 different quirks.
What?
Oh my god! Okay, it's happening! Everybody stay calm!
What's the procedure, everyone? What's the procedure?
Stay calm!
Wait.
Everybody calm down!
Okay, because not counting All Might, who was quirkless, Deku didn't have a quirk, and then the first brother, the first holder, everyone else had a quirk alongside having one for all. So Deku's gonna have 6 quirks manifest themselves, and he's gonna have to somehow learn to control them? Holy crap. Way to go, Deku. You went from zero to hero way quickly. You went from no quirk at all to now basically having 6-7 quirks if you're including all of those quirks and one for all on its own. You hit the jackpot. Control your heart and master us. Master all 6 of these quirks. Master all 4 elements. Do your best, boy. We're with you. You're going to be the one who completes one for all. Damn, as if it wasn't hard enough already for Deku to master 100% of One For All, but now you got to stack on top of that 6 different quirks. This is going to be interesting moving forward, but I'm kind of glad we're finally getting this answer that the quirks of the previous users were also incorporated within One For All, because I had, like, inklings that that could possibly be the case, and they turned out to actually be true. So our Hellboy is just vortexing out of there. I think we're exiting the dream. Ooh, and we got a double spread page right here. Yep, we're going back to the 5th and final match. Oh yeah, that match is still going on. Deku, and this is a good shot, by the way. I love this shot of Shinzo looking at the destruction, and you just see Ochako floating there with Deku. He did some damage right there to the surrounding area. Though that Black Whip quirk did some damage. Are you all right? Did my slap hurt? She slapped Deku awake from Shinzo's brainwashing. That's hilarious. And it wouldn't be the first time too that she had to slap Deku in order to save him. That's hilarious. Uraraka, get away from me. It's dangerous. We were able to calm it down with Shinzo's brainwashing, and we see Ochako floating Deku back down to the ground. Is everything good? Look at our girl Ochako right here, making sure that Deku is safe, he's okay, making sure he is not worried. She didn't hesitate at all and has done a fantastic job jumping in to ground zero of what was going on and assessed the situation and did the best that she could with Shinzo's assistance. A plus, Ochako, you did fantastic. Uraraka, you're hurt. What have I done? So, yeah, she's got a few scrapes and bruises here or there, but I have a feeling that this will affect Deku a little bit, knowing that he went out of control and that Ochako got a few scrapes and bruises trying to rescue him from that state.
Hello there.
Oh my god, Monoma. Holy shit. He does not hesitate at all. Monoma is taking this opportunity to attack Deku when he is dazed and confused. And he is surfing in on a nut. Monoma is surfing the nut right now. Monoma is surfing the nut. That is amazing. And Deku is shocked. He's like, what? Monoma's behind me? Hello? We're not done here, you know. We're still in our fifth and final match here. So he swipes at Deku. It looks like Deku was able to dodge that attack. And Deku is still shocked right now. He's trying to get his bearings. He's like, wait a minute. Monoma, what's going on right now? And Ochako is moving in. Wait a minute, would you? She didn't even hesitate. And she's going in with the gunhead martial arts. Nice callback right there. Man, if she was able to make contact, I don't think Monoma would be able to get out of gunhead martial arts right there. But we have some projectiles moving in. Ochako sees them, and she dodges. Both her and Deku dodge out of the way. We got our poltergeist girl. Are you two all right? What was that just now? Nice, poltergeist. So she came in and saved Monoma right there. Thanks to all that black stuff shooting everywhere, our plan got ruined. Mm-hmm. That is like the only response from Kodai. She only gives mm-hmms. It's never sentences or phrases. It's just mm-hmm. She's very simple in that way. But we also have Class A squad moving in with Ashido and Mineta. They're like, get out of here. We see just acid and balls flying everywhere. And Kodai blocks that from coming. Just says, mm-hmm, yet again. She must be a very easy conversationalist. She's a good listener, I bet. You could be like, so, Kodai, how's the weather? So, Kodai, how you doing? She just gets no dialogue. Midoriya, Uraraka, you okay? So, Ashido trying to assess the situation, see how her teammates are holding up right now. Ochako responds back, everyone's together. It's a melee. Oh my god, everyone's fighting right now. This right here is an all-out brawl. I like this shot right here. Mineta is like trying to dodge what Poltergeist and Kodai are throwing at her. Ashido is surfing on her acid. And our Saiyan Scouter guy is just getting ready to launch an attack. Like, damn, this shot is really cool. I like the way this panel looks right here. Everyone's getting ready to fight and just throw fists around. So Ochako is still with Deku. Deku still trying to assess what just happened. If you wield your power in anger, the power will respond accordingly. What's important is always being in control of your heart. Uh-oh. We got some type of tape or something coming towards Ochako. That's Shinzo's binding. It's Aizawa's scarf. He's throwing it at Ochako. Wow, he turned really quickly. Once the match picked up again, he stopped working with Ochako and immediately went in to try to capture her. Flipped on a dime. And Deku, even with all this stuff on his mind, did not hesitate to protect Ochako. He grabbed that shit out of the air. He's got it. And he's like, no, no, no. Not today. One for all. I've got so much in my head right now, I can hardly think. I can't allow myself to hurt everyone again. Deku has all these thoughts right now that he's just like trying to process everything that just happened. But he needs to put those aside because this match is continuing off. And I'm amazed that the teachers haven't stopped this yet. Like Aizawa hasn't stepped in and said, all right, guys, with everything that just happened, we're going to have to stop it right here. But no, this fifth match is continuing as if nothing happened. Speaking of teachers, we see Vlad, Aizawa, and All Might. They're on the battlefield. They made their way closer to the match, but it looks like they stopped a distance a ways. What should we do, Eraser? All Might. Let's keep watching for a bit. Aizawa, what are you? So Aizawa wants to keep this match going, and All Might's like, did you just see what Deku was doing before? We need to stop this so that way no one else gets hurt. Aizawa, what are you thinking right now? Ooh, and I like this bottom panel right here of Deku and Shinzo locking eyes. The fifth set shall continue. All right, fifth match is continuing as if nothing ever happened. And I think we're going to get a legit second matchup with Deku and Shinzo. With the way that they are looking at each other, I'm hoping that is the case. Because That's why Aizawa wants to continue the match. He's like, hang on, All Might. Let's see how our sons fare against one another. Let's see how our proteges, which one is better than the other. That's why he wants it to continue. You have the son of All Might and the son of Aizawa going up against one another. But I'm hoping we get a second match with these guys. But that is the ending of Chapter 213. And next issue, crashing in with a center color. It's about damn time. I feel like it's been so long since we've gotten a color page for My Hero. So something big is possibly going down next chapter. But this was a really interesting chapter. There's a lot to digest there with what was talked about with Hellboy, with the six quirks that Deku is going to be manifesting with One For All. And I'm really curious on how people are taking that. Like, what's the thought process there? Because for me, I've kind of always thought that the previous holder's quirks were somehow incorporated into One For All based on how Horikoshi has set it up and just reading through the series. That's just what my mind thought of with the crystallization of power of One For All. But I'm curious if this is kind of like shocking to some people, because honestly, I kind of expected the powers of previous holders to be incorporated in some way. But this just means that Deku, in order to master those powers, he's going to have to communicate with the previous holders, and hopefully by then, he unlocks his mouth in that smoke form, so that way we can have some good dialogue and conversations with the past holders. So with that, guys, that right there is my live reaction to chapter 213 of My Hero Academia. But now I definitely want to hear your guys' thoughts on this chapter, and I specifically want to hear your guys' thoughts on what we learned about One For All, about the six quirks that Deku is going to manifest, and what your guys' overall thoughts are with that. Did it blindside you? Or is it a positive? Is it a negative? Leave your thoughts down in the comments below. I really want to know your guys' thoughts. And also, how do you guys see this fifth match continuing and whether or not we're going to reach the conclusion next chapter? Leave your thoughts down in the comments below, guys. And if you want to talk more about My Hero, feel free to subscribe to the channel, but also follow me over on Twitter. That way you guys can get some updates and we can just talk about My Hero and other stuff over on that platform. So that's going to do it for me here, guys. So until hopefully next week, I believe next week we're going to have chapter 214 of My Hero Academia, but I'll talk to you guys next time. But remember, go beyond plus ultra.